Hello everybody, this is Pierre Garudi and tonight I'm going to answer another question which I received through the social media. And the question is, wholesaling marketplace shrinking in fashion? The answer is yes. It has been a couple of decades. Some chains started to sell directly to consumer without wholesaling any collection they make, rather than to wholesale into department store or other chains or independent boutiques. They just started directly to sell to the consumers, and it's nothing new. It's been for a couple of decades. Department stores were king in the 50s, 60s, 70s, even 80s, but eventually things start to change. As years pass, wholesaling, a traditional format, started losing market share almost every single year for the past couple of decades. The last market shares to the chain companies, which they were more focused on a certain customers in a narrow retailing format. The old format of having everything under the same roof is out of fashion and démodé and obsolete. But its legacies still stays on in some countries, although the numbers is very few and far between. Not only the number of department stores going down, but also the number of chains and independent shops are going down as well. Pandemic accelerated this crisis and compounded the little problem a fashion company had the pre-pandemic to a full blown out crisis. As we know, fashion industry is a rag business and very old fashioned, although in contrast they have to constantly have new fashions and new design to churn out every season. In many countries, department stores went bankrupt, like in US, Barney's New York, Neiman Marcus, JCPenney, and Lord & Taylor, and few others. The number is a long list. And if you want to find out more, just Google it. In every country in the world, most of the department store went out of business. Not just department stores, fashion chains and independent shops, they all went out of business. So the format of department store is disappearing, and not just department store, the chains and independent also similar ways. And designers, they have to look for somewhere else to sell their collection. Although some designers, they are big company or they are under a big conglomerate like Louis Vuitton, Moët Hennessy, LVMH, or Kering, or Richemont, and some other smaller ones. They can sell to them. But independent designers, they don't have such a financial capability and know-how to open their own stores or their own chains or department stores. That's not possible. So the pandemic changed everything. I mean everything, from supply chains to textile manufacturer to clothing factories to the retail shop and the consumers, all changed. Pandemic also created a few other problems. One of it is that designers, they want to get rid of the season. So some designers they're gonna follow their own instinct and they're gonna do it, and some designers not gonna do it. So fashion is no longer a united voice. So pandemic pushed everybody to be on their own. In order to survive, you have to find your own format. Now, add to the problem that pandemic created, add to it like things like sustainability and climate change and so many other big and small problems will all came out when the pandemic hit the society. So the technology disruption and the pandemic crisis forcing the change, and at least half of the businesses in fashion, from supply chain or textile manufacturer or factory, everything, okay, almost half of them, they're going to be out of business. Naturally, the change will get evolved, but the speed of change will increase. Every year goes on, the speed of change becomes faster and faster. And what is left is the survival of the fittest. And that is in very short period of the time, because the change is coming again and again, but faster. Now, quote of the day. Disruptive innovation can hurt. If you are not the one doing the disrupting. I hope I could answer the question. I hope I could add some value. So if you like it, please smash the like button, subscribe it, share it, and leave your comments. On the comments, your suggestions, your remarks, your question, or your critics, I will try to answer all of them. So good night. See you tomorrow night with another question and another answer. Bye.